コンペコ、コンペコ、コンペコ、ホロライフ3期生、宇佐田ペコラです。あ、どうも、あ、どうも。
アルマンド、アルマンド。
アルモンド、アルモンド。I have a brain disease and it's called I'm down the whole rabbit hole. Okay, based on the context, hold on. If you know what I said earlier, the rabbit hole saying sounds a little, I'm a little flustered now. That's a ooh.
Uh-oh. Well, I'm telling. No, I'm just...
Oh no. Yeah, it's me. I'm a VTuber. Look at me move. I'm an anime girl. This joke makes sense in an audio medium.
Sometimes you live long enough to hear yourself become the villain.
Dude, I like...
No, I've got... I feel you. I have gone full... Like, I watched a couple clips. I tripped into the rabbit hole. And at first I was like, oh, like, you know... Like, nah, I don't watch VTubers, man. Like, I just saw this clip, man. It's funny. It's a clip.
Yeah.
And now I'm unapologetically like, man, every time I log, like, Twitch is shit. There's just shit on there. I'm going to watch real live streams like fucking Corone playing Super Mario World and Sonic.
Dude, like, I've just... So it all started about a month ago. I started writing, like... My big brain thesis of, like, how did we get to VTubers? And mind you, I'm still writing it very slowly because in doing research, I have just become a fan.
Yeah.
And, like, 3 months ago, I would have been like, I was kind of like, you know, this shit's kind of cringe, but, like, you know, whatever, man. Fucking whatever. And... I mean, fuck it. I'm just out here to say it. I love VTubers.
Yeah, fuck it. I flipped. I love watching VTubers. I went for same thing. Oh, this is kind of cringe to like, oh shit, I get out of work just as Ina's fucking Jester drawing stream goes live. Hell yeah.
Yeah, like I cannot escape. It's a vortex. Like so they're in Hololive, this agency, one of the more prominent agencies. There's a member, Hosho Marine. She's not that she's not safe for work, but a lot of her discussions just lead places. One of the most famous things of her is her just unabashedly like learning what horny means and just being like, I'm horny.
Yeah, it's because fucking like there's another VTuber, Coco, who like knows English, and like side tangent, me and Franz had watched this video. I think I showed it to you and you explained it to me. There's a video of like, it says, oh, like, Coco failed her English test, even though she's, like, a native English speaker. And I was like, oh, that's weird, haha, she's just kind of quirky and dumb, I guess. Funny, haha. And then she says the name of the test she took, and apparently it's, like, the highest grade, like, English test you can take.
Like, it's... So, the way Japanese language testing works is incredibly flawed. I don't want to get too deep into it, but there's, like, 5 levels. 5 is the lowest, and that's basically elementary level. 1 is the highest, and that's basically, like, graduate level.
Yeah.
And you can see that there's, like, a huge disparity between that, right? Like, how the fuck are you supposed to go? So, elementary school students, they should be able to take the 5th level test. That's how kind of it works, though. Yeah. You know, they're elementary school students. They're not going to be, like, pressured into taking tests unless they want to. My junior high school students should be capable enough to take the 3rd level test. Then there's this huge gap to the 2nd test. So much so that there's, like, a quote-unquote pre-2nd and a quote-unquote pre-1st.
Holy
but how
shit.
Are you going to go from junior high school level English at the 3rd level to a graduate degree level?
Yeah.
At the 1st level. Like, it's Jesus absolutely Christ. Ridiculous. To the point where, like, I'm confident that, like, the average American might have some trouble with passing the test. Oh, the graduate level sure. test.
Nobody fucking, like, we speak the language, but I
we don't know.
It's so fucking bastardized that, like, nobody learns it, you know? Very few people actually learn all the rules. And it's gotten to a point where it's, like, English, like, at least colloquially, like, keeps evolving. So it's, like,
well, at a rapid rate. There's so much about it. And so, like, you know, whoever, like, subtitled the clip must have not known.
Yeah.
But, like, I was watching it, and I fucking, like, knew. And I was like, hold on. Because, like, I can tell that Coco's native English speaker.
Yeah.
She's probably native Japanese as well. But, like, no point really, like, theorizing about that. But, like, absolutely crazy that, like, they're like, oh, dumb can't take the first level test. And it's like, no, you don't understand.
You don't understand.
Yeah. Anyways, the fact that we've talked about this for 7 minutes, despite
shows having, how deep in the rabbit hole we yeah, are.
We're in really deep. I promise you, I am writing a script for it. I am in the process of it.
This is all for a reason, I swear.
I'm researching, I swear. I do not have the Horny Pirates theme song in my brain at all times. Ahoy, ahoy, ahoy.
Oh, God.
So, yeah, we're not talking about VTubers. Not again.
Yeah, we are, in fact. I just realized we didn't do the intro.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez.
Fuck us.
Oh, fuck, dude. We're deep.
We're too deep.
Oh, God. We are Paramecia Fancast, and we're a One Piece Fancast, not VTuber Fancast yet.
Though.
Where we review the latest chapter of One Piece and have a different One Piece related discussion every single week. My name is John.
My name is Franz, and we're not going to neglect this podcast, but.
Yeah.
Maybe. It's time for a VTuber podcast.
One of these days. Look, I saw last thing about VTubers, and then we can go on our merry way.
Oh, another 7 minutes.
But it's audio, so like there's no way, I guess, unless somebody transcribes it, but that does not exist probably. Marine and Fubuki, they have like a podcast where they just talk about, like, I think they talk about, like, music and stuff, or they talk about something. They talk about a whole bunch of shit. But
no way.
There was one where they had the songwriter who wrote We Are, like, the first One Piece theme song. They had him on, and they were just, like, talking to it. Like, I didn't understand shit, but just hearing them, like, talk about it, I was like, oh, shit.
That's so interesting. Honest, like, a good example of that in, like, English language is one of the Hololive English VTubers, Calliope Mori. She was on Gigix's vodcast.
Yeah, on Trash Taste, yeah.
Yes, yes, yes.
That shit was wild.
They just had her on as a VTuber, and that shit was so funny because, like, they brought it up a couple of times and were like, there's, like, agents here telling us, like, what we can and can't talk about, really.
Yeah. Like, they were there, and then, like, Giguk at the start of it is like, I can't, like, move. And he's laughing, and they're like, if you move, you fuck this whole thing up.
Because, like, they had her, like, basically, like, spliced into, like, their video feed. It was so funny.
Yeah.
Anyways, what we're talking about is a grand departure from this.
Yeah. You're gonna wish we stayed on VTubers, bitch. No, I'm just kidding.
So, like, all media, no matter what, is not, like, free from, like, any kind of, for lack of a better word, problematicness, you know?
Yeah.
Everything touches buttons, and, like, it's more of a matter of, how those buttons are touched and how often and the repercussions and this and that.
Yeah.
So today
I'll add on to it.
We're talking about how One Piece has hit those buttons in the past. We've talked about it, like, you know, in intermittently, like, between our usual chapter discussion.
Yeah.
But, like, the omnibus version of that today, as well as things we don't really talk about too often.
Yeah.
That, like, the issues that can be had with One Piece. We're diehard fans. We're not saying One Piece is bad for this. We're not saying we're indulging in something that's, oh, so bad.
Yeah.
No, like, we just should be critical of the things that we watch and the things that we read in order to, like, understand why those things are issues.
Yeah. And I just want to say, like, because I know people, like, it, like, okay, we're not about to just fucking shit all over one. Like, the series is horrible. Oda's a horrible person. Like, all this shit. Like,
yeah.
You can, I mean, we're going to get into it, but, like, you can talk about these things and, like, just sort of expand, like, your understanding of all this stuff and just, like, I don't know, you could talk about this stuff without completely berating, like, the series.
Yeah.
or make it, like, oh, like, I can't like One Piece now. Like, I'm not saying you can't. Like, after this recording is done, I'm still gonna tell everybody, yeah, One Piece is, like, one of the best stories ever written. Like, that's probably not gonna change for me, but it's also one of those things where it's, like, you can't just, like, swipe, like, the perfect example is, like, Dragon Ball. Like, you can't be like, oh, yeah, like, I really like Dragon Ball. And then if someone's like, yeah, but Mr. Popo's kind of fucked up, you can't just deny that. Like,
yeah, you can't run away from that. The same way, like, a good modern example is Harry Potter. That went through the shithole because J.K. Rowling's not a very misguided human being. Let's leave it very lightly, huh?
Yikes.
And it's the kind of thing that opened the door to, like, things that people have been saying for decades, that, like, it's really fucked up that, like, the they're not elves, the bankers, the goblins are basically like Jewish, like, caricatures.
They're just like every and they're Jewish bankers stereotype, like, shoved into one, and it's like, how did she get away with this?
And it's not, no one's claiming that was her intention, but, like, it's something that, like, it can be read that way, and because it can be read that way, we should be critical of it. People still love Harry Potter, like, this and that, while still being critical of it. Like, you know, there's no point in, like, we're all adults here.
Yeah.
We can all admit when shit fucks up.
Yeah.
Another different example that John and I talked about was, like, Attack on Titan. And Attack on Titan feels different because, so, like, the goblins are one facet of Harry Potter, right? And, like, you know, if you don't like the hero's journey kind of stories, the chosen one shit that Harry Potter is, you know, that's on you. I personally don't like it either, but that's just taste. Whereas Attack on Titan feels, it's very on the nose that it's, like, it's talking about very dangerous things.
Yeah.
And it's very, like, you have learned about the Holocaust, it's pretty yikes.
Yeah. It's weird because, like, I know the guy has the Ishiyama, I think, is the author.
No clue.
I believe, I know that he's, like, said some shit that's real sort of, like, pro-imperialist, sort of, like, you know, pro... Which isn't, like, that... I'm not saying it's not bad, but it's, like, for figureheads in Japan, it's... If I hear a Japanese guy say something like that, it's not like, oh my god, like, what the fuck? Like...
It's not surprising.
Yeah, yeah, it's like, okay, like, that... It kind of makes sense, I guess, that he would say that. Like, it's, like...
It's unfortunate, really, you know, like, that's just the state of the matters in Japan.
Yeah,
but,
yeah.
Like... It goes further than that when you, like, read.
Yeah, yeah. And I'm not trying to say, like, he's completely, like, you know, I'm not saying he's trying to fucking, like, bring, like, yeah, the Nazis had it right. But it's, like, when he says stuff like that, and then you read the story and like you see what's going on, at least in the first like half of the story, like it's definitely pretty yikes. Where it's going now is just like, I don't know. He's making it like he's going the Code Geass route, where like the main character is just dragging the entire world down with him in order to like
start make it better.
Yeah, to start anew and shit like that. It's getting weird. It's one of those series where it's like I'm keeping an eye on it, like because I just want to see how it ends. Like now that it's so close, the same.
You've same invested thing. So much into it, yeah.
Yeah, because it's like I'm not the biggest, like I'm not even really like a big fan of Attack on Titan, but it's just one of those things where it's like it's piqued my interest so much over the years with all this shit that's happened around it and in the story that I'm like I need to see this to its end. Like,
yeah,
but it is really fucking weird. Like the I remember the one chapter I read that talks about like it talks about them sending the people to the Island of Paradise, like the Eldians, I think it is, that get sent, and it's just fucking like I mean, it's straight up like there's a character who like is explicitly told like, oh, like sell out your family, like if you sell out your family, we'll give you like a position in the military, like, you know, you can join our side, you don't have to be with them or whatever, and he fucking sells out his family. I'm like, yo, bro.
there's a lot of like things that happen from what I've heard. I haven't read it, so like I really can't attest to some of it, but like what we're getting at for like One Piece is that it's not necessarily at the level of Attack on Titan, where like the author himself has like really not so great ideals, and yeah, when you read it you can see that really come through, and so it's like a whole like mishmash vortex of like, oh yeah, yikes.
Yeah,
One Piece has had very shaky moments, but it's definitely like out of learned ignorance,
yeah,
more so than anything.
I was just about to say, I feel like a lot, if not all, of the moments that are like yikes in One Piece are literally just like just born from Oda's ignorance of the matter. Like he just, yeah, he just didn't know, and it's like, well, shit. Like and some of those have had moments in the manga recently where it's like, okay, he's learning, like he's learned, you know, he's getting better. I mean, I point to Okiku for that, because it's like, you know, the very first, like, you know, like non-binary character we see is like the character is definitely non-binary, right? Because like there's a part in Alabasta where Bonclay is literally like, he explicitly says, or Oda explicitly says, oh, like, it was in an SBS, and they're like, oh, well, like everybody in Baroque Works has they're male and female pairs, but like, how come Bonclay's by himself? And Oda explicitly says in the SBS, like, oh, like he doesn't feel that he's really man or woman. Like he is whatever he wants to be, so that he's his own tag team. And it's like, wow, yeah, that's pretty, all right, that's, yeah, that's
it's surprisingly like
in the story, that was a pretty good answer. And then you see how like Bonclay
almost
looks
20
like,
years
oh,
ago
shit.
Honestly. Like that was quite a bit ago, and like, yeah, it's a very good answer to that kind of thing. Like it's like it does hold Bonclay in a kind of way. It more or less stereotypes him without knowing what that stereotype would be. It's kind of like, you know, I don't know if Oda has like met non-binary people, has them in his life, yeah, or whatnot, but without any kind of perspective, it's very easy to just like caricaturize someone like that. And you could say that detail is a caricature, but I'm more of the philosophy of like, so I being like non-binary, like agender myself, like there's no fucking representation at this point. I'll take that factoid, like especially ignoring the fact that he basically has like in his jacket basically says faggot on it, like,
yeah, the Okama, like,
yeah, Like, that's...
Which, that's the thing I point to, which is, like, that's just, like, just ignorance on his part, because it's like, he just, you know, he probably grew up thinking, like, oh, like, yeah, like, I mean, the same way, like, you know, like, we all went to high school, like, I was definitely...
Yeah.
I was definitely at some point on 4chan, and I definitely thought that slur that I'm not allowed to say was funny.
It's yeah.
Like, and you just kind of grow out of it, and then, like, you reach a point where you realize, like, oh, shit, like, wow, yeah, no, that's, like...
Like, it's the kind of thing where, like, you know, it's not as bad as it could have been, considering yeah. a lot of things, but it's still a point that we have to be very critical on Oda about. Like, yeah. he's done Kiku well so far.
Yeah.
But Yamato, it's been, like a kind of a bit of a mess of, like, yeah. do you want to call him Kaido's daughter? Do you want to call him, like... It's confusing as a reader, no yeah. matter, like, where you sit on either side of, like, Yamato's pronouns, gender. Like,
yeah.
The fact that it's a discourse is because of, like, confusion from
yeah,
the author.
Because of the inability for him to, like, cement it. I mean, like, you could argue he has, because, like, I mean, again, like we've said, like, every single character, including Yamato, refers to himself as he. Including yeah. his father, Kaido. Like, if the Yonko is fucking calling him he, then until otherwise stated, I'm gonna call him he. But, you know, the fact... And then it's like, that's a thing. So it's like, okay, he's he. But then it's like, oh, Kaido's daughter. And then, like, I went back and I read it. And, you know, I can't read the Raws. But as far as I could tell, like... Ace in the flashback never actually referred to Yamato in any sort of, like... He never referred to Yamato's gender.
Yeah.
Like, when he talked to Yamato, he was just, like, talking. But he never said anything that, like, kind of implied or referred to Yamato's gender. Which is a whole, like, okay, well, like, was he told off-screen? Does he know? Like, what's going on? I think there was only one moment where it was, like... And it was two tiny-ass panels before the page turn. It was, like, a character's like, oh, that's... I've heard stories, that's Kaido's daughter. And then Yamato has, like, this fucking, like she clicks her teeth, like, god damn it, like...
Yeah.
So it's one of those things where it's like, well, fuck, like...
Yeah.
It's one of those things where it's like, it's with Kiku, he did it fantastic. And with Yamato, yeah. it's very obvious that he's trying to, like, do something with that in the story. But I just feel like he didn't do a very good... He tripped along the way.
Right.
And thus it's leading the kind of to thing, the like, confusion.
We will have to see.
Yeah.
Another issue that does come up that I feel like it doesn't come up that often. It's like a very small subset of One Piece fans who are... Like, they try to be more vocal, but, like, they're so small. Like, and One Piece is such a large community.
Yeah.
That, like, in Dragon Ball, the whole Mr. Popo thing, unfortunately, One Piece and Oda being so influenced by Dragon Ball, you know, fate would have it that it would happen again, like, chapter 2 or something, I think it was.
It's when he runs into Buggy. Buggy on his crew has, like, this very stereotyped black kid on his crew, and it's like, oh... Oh, so we're just gonna look like the racist Bugs Bunny cartoons when the gun blows up on his face. We're just doing that, I guess.
Yeah, like, he was dropped so hard that yeah. he doesn't even have a name.
Yeah.
Because, like, so the he's, like, one of the only dark-skinned characters in the whole series. And, like, but like, I feel like... The biggest issue people have is the whole, like, sausage lips, because that has its own history. It's not like, oh, black people have thick lips or whatnot. It harkens back to minstrel shows with the whole blackface thing.
Yeah.
And, like, white people dressing up and, like, blackfacing and being like, look at me, I'm a dumb black person. and I'm so dumb, look at me, oh look, I hate women, I will do bad things to women. Like, that whole history has not escaped anime, like, because of the whole, yeah, this need to just do the Mr. Popo.
Yeah.
And, like, so Oda, instead of being like, oh shit, let me not do the lips thing, he pulled a Dragon Ball Kai, and instead of making Mr. Popo's, like a normal fucking character with normal anatomy, he made Mr. Popo blue. And by that, I mean Oda in One Piece just has not really shown any character with, like, remotely dark skin color.
Yeah, it's fucking wild. I'm actually looking right now at the One Piece, the WT 100, the world's top 100.
Yeah,
I'm in, dude, East Blue. That guy has been erased from history. Like, he's not here at all.
And like, WT 100 has, like, it's
everybody.
Yeah, everyone is here
except for this one guy.
like Oda or editors clearly feel shame about this.
Yeah,
but they corrected the wrong thing. It's the kind of thing, like, Usopp still has, like, the whole, like, sausage lips thing.
Yeah, he has, like, very coded features that are, like...
Yeah, and like, even, like, in SBSs, when, like, they're like, oh, if they were from Earth, like, where would they be from? The first time Oda answered it, he was like, Africa, and it's like, that's not a country, but okay.
Yeah.
Like, people, whatever. But, like, it's been more, like, pushed towards, like, him being, like, Kenyan, I believe.
I think I'll have so, to look.
Yes, okay. I'm so smart. Vexology on the mind.
Vexology.
I know flags. So, like, they're pushing him towards that direction, but it's, like, okay, like, give him, like, features like that. Like, it's really cool, and, like, some people do appreciate the representation of, like, a character with, like, nappy hair. That, yeah, in and of itself is quite a lot and quite meaningful. But, like, again, they just corrected the wrong thing. They made Mr. Popo blue.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, it's fucking crazy. Because, like, Usopp post time skip still has some of that stuff, but it's, like...
Yeah, it's really just the lips, honestly.
Yeah.
That's, like, the only thing about it. And, you know, the other thing is that there's just, like, no black people in One Piece.
Yeah.
And, you know, I feel like making arguments, like, are often made for, like, fantasy, like, oh, like, there's just, like, no black people around there. And it's, like, that's kind of a preposterous thing to say for, like, an Earth analog.
Yeah.
Like if you're making, like, a whole new world for your fictional environment, and you're just gonna, like, remove black people, that says something about you. I'm not saying that this is, like, the direction that Oda took. It was just course correction that went way too far.
Yeah.
And I don't, like...
And part of me wonders if it's maybe a thing of, like, he doesn't want... He knows... Because, I mean, obviously erasing that character, like, he knows he... like, did a boo-boo, right? Like, he knows.
Yes.
It's very apparent he knows, because that character got Thanos snapped. Like, that character is gone.
But Pepperidge Farms remembers.
Yeah, Pepperidge Farms remembers. But, like, part of me wonders if it's a thing where, like, maybe him or maybe the editors are just, like, way too...
nervous. They're
way too afraid or nervous to even try to do that, because they think any attempt at that will be... I'm just explaining pretty much, like, you know, in a roundabout way, like, white guilt, I guess.
Right.
They don't want to, I feel like maybe it's a thing where they don't even want to bring it up, and then not because they think just the fact of them bringing it up will be taken negatively, but it's like, no, like, where he is now with what he's been doing, I would trust Oda if there was just some black characters, like,
yeah,
thrown in. Like, oh, and, like, okay, cool.
you know, I'm not saying, like, put black people in Wano. Like, Wano's very clearly a, like, Japanese-like analog.
Yeah.
You know, it, like, feudal Japan at that. Like, I'm not saying that, like, if Oda wants to be, like, somewhat historically accurate with this, like, fictional analog, you know, power to him. Yes, Japan still is, but was an ethnostate. And, like, you know, I'm not saying to, like, introduce it there for, like, posterity points. That's not good either. Just, like, adding in token characters is not solving an issue. Like, when you are such a big series that you are close enough to rival the Bible, you should have, as an author, I feel like it should be some sort of responsibility to be like, well, I want this, if it's being read around the world like this, I want people to find, like, joy in this. And, like, what supreme joy, what joy would be more supreme than seeing an aspect of yourself written into the manga? I can't tell you how happy I am to see Kiku represented well. I'm not a trans woman, but just that in and of itself, it just feels like, oh shit.
Yeah.
I am seen, and I am seen to have value. It's important.
Yeah. No, it's definitely important. I mean, we had talked about it before recording too, but, like, every time this topic comes up, like, of inclusion, especially of, like, black characters, I always point to Kishimoto and Tite Kubo.
Kubo
had some of the sickest characters in Bleach were black, and I fucking loved it, because it was never sort of tokenism, like, oh, like, I have to include this character. It was literally just, oh, this character's cool, I'm gonna draw this character and they're black. Like, that's it. Yeah. That's, like, it's been so long since I read Bleach. I just remember the shark hollow girl.
Yeah.
One of the Espadas or whatever, and then the blind guy who followed Aizen. They were, like, the two of the fucking coolest characters. And also, there was a whole bunch of fucking, like, Mexican characters. Speaking of inclusion, I was hyped when they're like, oh yeah, Chad is from Mexico. I was like, oh yeah, let's go.
Yeah, no kidding.
The,
like,
best character. The best character, and he's my people's.
The absolute coolest. And then there's, like,
and Kishimoto, you know, too. Like, Kishimoto, like, all of the cloud ninja. I mean, you know, I don't know. I guess an argument can be... Well, not even. I'm thinking about it now. Because I was going to say, I guess an argument can be made, like, oh, well, he just, like, sidelined them to, like, their own country. But it's like, he had already shown beforehand, like, he had actually done a pretty good job of showing the world before, like, the end of Naruto.
Yeah. Because,
like, each country had, like, their own different shit, and it was, like, visible, like, you could see the differences within, like, the characters from different countries. So it's like, oh shit, okay. Yeah. Like, that's actually really cool.
And, like, you know, we didn't get to see, like, so much, like, like, it's really clear that, like, Kishimoto planned out so much of the world, and we didn't get to see all of it in its, like, totality. But, like, the fact that he, like, planned out and tried to show as much as he could, and like, these different areas, like, you know, just seeing the, like, just seeing the kind of, not diversity, because it's still, like, not that, like, widespread, but just the thought to have characters of all different shapes, all different sizes. Oda does this as well, just without skin tone.
Yeah.
But, like, that kind of philosophy towards character design specifically is really important.
Oh yeah, it's so good. And it's just, it's one of those things where it's like, it's like, you know, One Piece has been going for so long that, like, I mean, I feel like if he does it now, it, like, now this late in the game, after he's already been like, oh yeah, like, it's about to end. Like, I know there's going to be people that are going to try to troll and be like, oh, well, it's too late now. But it's like, I would argue that it's never too late.
Right.
With an asterisk, like, unless you're on the fringe, like, the very last chapter.
Yeah, like oh, the last 10 chapters or something, that is a little too late.
Yeah.
Jesus like Christ. If Odo pulled like Raftel has black people, that's where they've been the whole time. That'd be kind of like, dude, what?
Jesus, what? Yeah. Like, really, dude?
Like,
absolutely fucking wild. That would be a moment where it'd be like, you know, okay, little too late, Oda. Just a tad bit too late. You kind of missed the fucking bus on this one.
Nah, like, I personally don't think that kind of change will happen here.
Yeah.
I don't know if Oda will write anything after One Piece. I don't think it, if it happens, I don't think it would be as long. It would be nice to see, because like a lot of people don't believe that Oda can like draw, but like when the man has to put out, he has to put out. He locked in character designs 20 years ago. He definitely has improved since then.
Yeah. It's no, anybody saying like, oh, Oda can't draw, like, dude, what are you smoking? Because I want some of that. I want some of that world, like, denying juice.
I want to see what Oda can do next. Another aspect, and this is, like, I will admit, it does get kind of, like, nitpicky to a certain degree, but the closest thing we do have to, like, people of color in One Piece that are, like non-Asian and then like not Zoro, Luffy, like the closest thing we have towards like black people would be the fishmen. And like there's definitely a what's it called,
there's definitely a parallel. I mean, you could see by like,
yeah, it's a metaphor.
I mean look at Fisher Tiger, like his hairstyle is definitely, I feel like his hairstyle is definitely supposed to represent like a black character, you know.
Like, there's that, and there's, like, also the history of slavery.
Yeah,
And all this other thing, and being, like, completely, like, secluded. There's a lot. It's pretty on the nose. But there's also, like, a bit of an aspect of kind of, like, and this is more of a criticism of media as a whole. It's not just One Piece.
Yeah.
Because why does media, when media has to show black people and the plight of black people, why do they have to turn into animals? It's the kind of thing where that analogy is used so often so that, like, I don't want to get too deep into it. I will just suggest to you, the listener, if you have 30 minutes, watch this very interesting video by a YouTuber called Jack Saint. If you look up Jack Saint Zootopia, you'll find the video in which he talks about, like, the Zootopia and two other movies I can't be fucked to remember because I... fuck me, I guess.
Yeah.
But all of these movies have the common thing of, like, oh, carnivores and herbivores, but oopsie daisies, the carnivores are the black people, or like it's a messy analogy. And
yeah,
like,
he talks about it in the video. I highly recommend watching that video and then watching
it's not
recommend,
like,
recommend going into his Beastars video like directly after that, because he ties the two together, like talking about like what Zootopia did wrong versus what Beastars does right and also does wrong at the same time. Like,
right, because like his whole thesis is like, when do we stop talking about people, like this media being an analogy for people, and when do we start talking about like animals?
Yeah,
because like the whole herbivore carnivore thing, that's animals, like that's nature, baby. But like when you're pushing that metaphor into a human metaphor, it's very weird, and you can suddenly start reading the wrong things in. You're not supposed to. Like, and like these movies are pretty clear about their, like, you know, anti like discriminative kind of things, and like you know, we should all live together happily ever after kind of messages. They're very clear about that, but like it's messy enough that it's like, well, okay. I bring that up because it's it's not necessarily the issue with Fishman Island. It's just Oda fell into the hole of using that cliche, that trope of like black people equals animal.
Yeah.
And it's like,
it's one of those things, dude. It's so weird because, like, again, in the Jack Saint video, he describes it as like he says, like, oh, the writers of Zootopia, like, he has no doubt in his mind they did not intend it this way. But it's just like when you use that metaphor, like, oh, they're animals now. Like, now when you're describing the animal side of things, it's like, because you've made the comparison, now it's like, well, wait, like you said, the carnivores are being discriminated against. Are you saying like black people are like, you know, like these monsters that give in to like their, like they have the like
primal
this,
urges.
Yeah, this primal urge, like they can't control it, but the herbivores, like what are you trying to say? And it's just one of those things where it's like, no, that's not what we meant at all, but it's because you used like an animal character to represent humans, yeah, that it's sort of that sort of thing, if you're not careful, can happen like it did in Zootopia.
And
I don't think it's happened quite
not as bad.
Quite as bad, if like really at all, other than just like the base, like, oh, like the,
like, why are they, like, animals?
Yeah, why are they animals? Like, I don't think it's gotten as bad as Zootopia did, but
yeah, it's literally like just the foot in the door of the issue.
Yeah.
That's as far as it's gotten. It hasn't really like hit anything else as an issue. Like I said, it's just like the trope as is kind of like, I believe that we should be moving away. Like, you're trying to humanize disenfranchised people.
Yeah.
Why are you going to use a metaphor that dehumanizes them in some capacity, like, be it literal or metaphorical? So, you know, Oda definitely did not like drop the ball as bad as like some other things like that. Like, you know, even like some newer anime, BNA, Brand New Animal by Studio Trigger. Yeah. I think it is top-notch media, but it still hits the pitfalls, and it's still stuck in the tropes of, like, disenfranchised people are now animals.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's not good when you're writing something to make the people who are already others just other them again, even more so.
Look, if we other them enough, eventually it'll be like
full,
like,
circle.
It'll be like a Civ 1 Gandhi, where he'll go to zero and then he'll go lower and jump back to 99.
Yes, clearly, it'll be a Stack Overflow. That's what's happening. Goodness. No, like, again, like the whole thing is like, we want to like bring up these issues. We're not like here to be like, oh, there's a fucking piece of poo poo caca doo doo. And like, you know, it's the kind of thing where like we have the advantage of hindsight. We're like, One Piece is 20 some fucking years old.
Yeah.
You know, like not just like the whole argument of like, oh, that was okay for the time. Like, just we're looking into like a very vast past, so to speak. And we have the benefit of just being like, oh, of course that's wrong. Because we're sitting here in our high horse,
yeah,
reading down and being like, ah, yes, Oda, you piece of shit.
Yes, loon, delightful, a chalice full of our own farts, just smelling.
Exactly. Like, direct pipeline, butthole to nose.
Yeah.
When at the same rate, like, we could do this. Like, I pick up projects and I put them down as fast as I pick them up. Like, I've had ideas for like a lot of different things and a lot of this and that. A good example is like, I'm very interested in Ainu people, the native people in northern Japan. And because like I've met them and this and that, and I think it would be really cool for more stories to include them other than like Golden Kamuy, which is a great example, honestly. Like,
yeah.
If you pick up a volume of Golden Kamuy and go to the end, there's a bibliography. Like, yeah.
It's that, insane.
That's a good example of being like, look, I tried.
Yeah.
But like, you know, I personally don't feel like I could do a story about Ainu people justice because like, yes, I met them. Yes, I learned so much. But like, I'm also like neither a scholar in this nor Ainu myself. So like, is it really my place to write this kind of thing?
Yeah. Is it your story to tell, you know?
Exactly. I'm lucky that I have that single shred of foresight preventing me from possibly making a mountain of fuck ups.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
But like, that's because like I've been lucky to have fucked up before, yeah. You know? And so again, the whole crux of this conversation is like, we should be aware of these things. We should point them out. We should look back, but we're not trying to spread our butt cheeks and then poop onto Oda because we have the benefit of hindsight.
Yeah. Yeah. It's, I don't know. This issue is definitely a tough one for anybody to like, look at. I'm not trying to be like, oh, like only support like, you know, authors that do this right or only do that. Like, you know, you can read whatever you want to read. Like, that's what I'm going to keep doing. But you also have to recognize that these are going to be issues sometimes. And it's like, and it's mm-hmm. not necessarily a bad thing. It's not a bad thing if you take something and learn from it, you know?
Right.
Like, if you read Dragon Ball and, like, you see Mr. Popo and your big takeaway is like, oh, haha, Mr. Popo funny, and that's it, then it's like, okay, hold on. Like, maybe you need, do you want another volume to sort of, like...
Yeah, do you want to run that back one more time?
Yeah, do you want to redo? You know, same thing in One Piece. Like, if you see, like, it in the beginning, like, the way...
This unnamed character who was wiped from fucking history. Yeah,
that, or even, like, the, you know, the whole Sanji during his time skip, like, on the Okama Island, like...
Yeah,
Okama Land, like...
The whole concept of Okama Land, just painting them as, like, transphobic caricatures. You know... It's unfortunate that shit is still funny to Japanese media.
Yeah.
Like, that's still a punchline. And so, like, to certain, like, Oda is at fault because Oda's the one who did it, but the issue does not stop at Oda.
Yeah.
Like, it's much larger than him. Like, I saw blackface in Japanese national TV, like, 2 years ago.
Jesus Christ.
Like, and yet you still have like testimonials from like directors or some shit refusing to hire black people who do live in Japan, like, because they're scary or some fucking shit.
Yeah,
you know, there's, like,
oh, it's whew, wild. There, I will say, there's recently, if you're on our Discord, not super super recently, I think it was like a couple months ago.
I don't know what time is.
Yeah, I don't know what time is. I read through all of Air Gear, and like, God, what an amazing manga! Like, I fucking love it. But the beginning of the manga, one of the first characters that joins the team, is this big black guy, who by the end of the series is one of the coolest fucking characters. He's one of my favorites.
Just like Bon Clay.
But in the beginning, when they introduce him, holy shit. Like, holy shit, sign of the times. Like, they did not, like, oh my God, they did not portray him in a very, very flattering light.
Yeah, like...
That shit was wild.
It's really bad, and, like, to get more into, like, the denser politics as an example when it comes to Japan, it's the kind of thing where, like, so, how do I put this? There's this, like, treaty in Japan. I forget the fucking name of it, but what it does, what it's supposed to do is prevent, like, human trafficking of children. That's a really noble goal. It's something that should be aspired. And, like, it's something that, like, should be talked about, should be legislated.
Yeah.
What it actually does is it makes it very, very fucking hard if you are a mixed-raced family living in Japan to, like, do anything with your child. Go to the airport, like, take out paperwork, you know, things that you would do as a family.
Yeah.
Slightly outside of everyday life.
Well, shit, even recently he tweeted about it. Gaijin Hunter, he is a, I forget where he's from in the U.S. He's said it before, but he's from the United States, and he lives in Japan with his daughter. And I guess recently...
And the daughter's Japanese.
Yeah, the daughter's Japanese. He moved to Japan. He got married.
Things happened.
He had a daughter, yeah. And now he has custody of his daughter. But, fuck, what is it? You have to remind me, because it's like the family registration thing. And like because he is like an American, like basically if the daughter is not on his mother's registry, like she just... doesn't exist according to the Japanese government.
So it's part of an issue of just so okay, the way Japanese registry works, if you are ethnically and nationally Japanese, is incredibly excellent because you yourself can go to your city hall and like trace your family lineage all the way down to the beginning of this registry a couple hundred years ago. That's fantastic, but so many things are tied to this registry that it really does lead to discrimination, because it'll go so far back to like some records of feudal times when like, oh, this person comes from a samurai family. People still talk about that in 2021 now, like as if that fucking matters. Like, what's he gonna do, like Iaido my fucking ass and cut me in like three pieces? Like, he's not.
Yeah.
He's a fucking bitch boy who's drunk on the street. I don't care.
Yeah, I know these nuts, boy.
So, like, that's something that, like, people are put, like, higher on the pedestal because of the registry. If they're so Japan used to have a caste system. The lowest rung of the caste is known as Barakumin. They are people who, through several different beliefs, they were basically required to handle dead bodies, handle fecal matter, this and that. And because of that, they were seen as dirty, cursed, unpure, etc., etc. And that, like, I had a coworker tell me that, so her daughter's kind of estranged from her because, like, I don't fucking know why. But her daughter came back to her being like, Mom, I need access to the family registry because it's passed down through familial ties. And she was like, okay, why do you need access? And it's like, I need to prove to my fiance's family that I don't have any quote-unquote tainted heritage.
What the fuck?
Dude, this was last year.
Dude, last year was like last week.
That's what I'm fucking saying, dude. So, like, it's literally the equivalent of just, like, meeting your boyfriend's parents for the first time and the parents being like, you got any black in your kid?
Yeah,
like,
whoa,
it's so fucking outlandish.
Yeah,
to me at least. Apparently this is fucking normal in
Jesus
Japan.
Jesus Christ, yeah, that's fucking wild.
And so, like, these records hold so much in society that, like, it affects your, like, the example, your fucking marriage. It affects your fucking work. Workplaces, if they're like a powerful enough company, they can get access to these records. But if you are still in custody to like a foreign person, it's so impossible to get those access to that paperwork, access to that, because the foreign parent basically acts as a blockade to that family registry. You are now under that foreign person who has a new registry, who is, that registry is at most 10 years old or something, right?
Yeah.
Like, I was having a conversation. I have a student who, she's half Japanese, half American. Her mom, her parents, they lived in America for quite a bit. And then, like, I think around the time they had her, came to Japan, this and that. Like, she looks like a white girl. I know that she's a foreign kid because, like, I see her in this and that. Like, you know, that aside, I actually happened to meet her mom. Funny thing is, I'm recording this. I have E. coli right now. I have an E. coli infection.
But surprise.
While I was at the hospital, I met her mother. Like, she was helping us out because, like, I was too in pain to fucking halfway Japanese. And so, like, she was, like, called in. I was like, I know your last name. Do you have a daughter in this school and whatnot? And I was like, this and that. But, like, we were talking, she has the same fucking issue, and she's Japanese, but her kid, like, has paperwork under the foreign name. So, like, it just works all fucking ways.
Yeah. This whole thing is fucking wild.
Like, and I kind of got lost in the sauce for a second. I forgot how we even got here. But, like, this goes to show to you that, like, you know, yes, we must be critical of Oda if Oda were to ever do something. But, like, we must also see the larger things, like, these issues like transphobia and this and that, they're not born in a single person. Yeah, it's a societal thing. We learn these things.
Yeah.
You know, if you put, I have a friend, she's a trans woman, she's a kindergarten teacher. Like, these kids are not going to be like, you're a fucking man, this and that. They might because of her voice or something like that. She passes well enough, I believe, but that's neither here nor there. Like, they're not going to be like, you're a fucking man, you're going to sexually harass me or this and that. Like, why do you have a penis? Yeah. Like, you know, none of that shit. These kids are just going to be like, I mean, shit, if you say you're a woman, I guess you're a woman. What do I know? I'm a kid.
Yeah.
You know,
I'm a little baby. Who cares?
I'm a baby. I'm no shit. I'm gonna poop my pants.
Yeah. Listen, dude. I don't care. Like this little kid talking. Listen, I don't care what you are. Get me my Play-Doh.
Yeah. Where's the fucking Play-Doh? So it's something to keep in mind while also having the conversation we've just had.
Yeah, I would say with any media, like. Again, I want to emphasize, because I feel like when this discussion happens, people just like to close up and be like, oh, well, you're just hating on everything. Like, no, like, I love all of these series. Mm-hmm. Like, I love all of them. And it's like, but to just blindly ignore the problems with them is not, like, it's not
very
gonna,
unproductive.
Yeah, it's not going to make the series any worse for anybody. Like, just because I'm like, oh, yeah, I like One Piece, like, I think Ivankov is kind of weirdly done. Like, I don't like how Oda did that. Like, that doesn't immediately mean that, like, your life is shattered and One Piece is garbage. Like, no, it's fucking amazing. It's just, like, you know, with all of your media consumption, like, just be aware of, like, these things that happen and call them out when they're bad. Like,
shit, dude. I forgot the whole reason this idea came to me. I finished watching this series on Netflix called Kipo and the Age of the Wonder Beasts. I like...
Oh, I've heard of that.
It's pretty good. But again, it does the fucking thing where, like, the disenfranchised people are animals, except they're literally animals.
Oh, no.
And so, like, that's something to, like, I'm tired. I'm personally tired of the trope. Yeah. So... It's a frustration I have, but I do suggest the series. It's very good. Like, for it being, like, it's a very carefully crafted piece of children's media. And they handle several things, like, very well. There's, like, a gay kid or whatever. The whole coming out of that was, like, handled very well. And, like, this and that. Like, it's good. Hell yeah. Like, I personally have to recognize as well that, like, that's, like... Come on, y'all. You couldn't have done something else? You couldn't have done... Like, we're at Zootopia 6.
Yeah, stop copying Zootopia. Like, see, I like Beastars a lot, because it starts like, oh shit, you think it's just Zootopia, and then it's like, oh...
No, it's about good. The animals.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, okay. It's about the animals. But yeah, that's that's all I got on that. Just
right.
Watch and read whatever you want, and it's probably fantastic.
Yeah.
But just also be cognizant of like when these things appear, because if they become a real problem and they're not called out, not to say that we're like fucking lambasting Oda, but like when yeah. there is an actual problem and we do have to call it out, like fucking like characters in blackface and shit, then it's like, okay.
Yeah, we gotta like it's yeah. it's kind of like a bit of a human duty. Do we have to do it all the time? No, neither that as well, because that does get exhausting. Like, we do need time to just do the shit we like and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like, but it's the kind of thing where, like, if you're in a position like we are, we have this, how do you fucking say this? This thing, the thing you're listening to currently. You're here. There's at least five people listening to us.
In our mind realm.
Yes. This mind palace that we've created. We have a platform. That's what I was fucking looking for. We have a platform. So we should be talking about it and whatnot. But like, if you're just like living your life and just like doing your thing, like who are you going to tell about like, Oda doing the Mr. Popo to yourself? Like are you just gonna like yeah. point that out to yourself and be like, damn, that's pretty fucked up? Like, no, don't be hard on yourself either.
Yeah it's tough. People want to take all of this stuff in extremes, because every time I see this sort of thing pop up or like be talked about, people like to be just you have to be extreme about it. You either have to be like against it like all the time 100%, or like if you're not, you're completely complicit with everything. It's like, there's nuance.
Yeah.
There's nuance to all this.
With absolutely everything, to tie it all the way back around, you didn't think we could, but we will.
Oh, shit. Like,
unfortunately, VTubers have said the N-word accidentally several times at this rate.
Yeah.
And, like, it's the kind of thing where, like, as an American, it's like, oh, my Lord. Like, how the fuck? But, you know, we got to take a step back and be like, is a Japanese person that, like, has never been to America, or never really experienced anything about America, gonna know
yeah.
what the N-word is? No.
Are they gonna understand the weight and significance? No,
they're gonna hear the iconic scene. Yeah.
Yeah. They're gonna hear Lamar sing it, and then they're just gonna repeat it because they're like, oh, okay.
Yeah. So, like, you know, unfortunately, yeah, everything's a little fucked, but like, I don't know.
There's nuance, like, bro. Like, yeah, they yeah. said it, but it's like, look at the context around it. Did they mean it? Like,
the worst thing was like, when you brought up, so there's one VTuber also in Hall Alive. There was the one that got very popular for having said the N-word, and then there's like another one who like also did it in that context, but another time after, like, she was like reading off like super chats or something, and you had told me the guy who his name was Nigel.
Yeah, his name was Nigel,
and like
L's and R's are kind of like the same sort of
so like
syllable.
It's not only just that; it's the way you would read everything about that name from like so like the you wouldn't your first thought. As a Japanese native speaker, wouldn't be to pronounce it Nigel.
Yeah, you wouldn't.
It would pronounce the literally hard I. be hard R, the N word.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it would sound almost exactly like that.
Yeah.
As your first instinct as a Japanese person, and she got corrected immediately on that same stream, and immediately apologized to the point of crying.
Yeah, she was like, she typed out a long message because she realized like what she said, and it was like, oh, like, I love you guys, like I would never do anything on purpose to hurt you, like I'm so sorry, like I didn't mean it, I didn't know. And I had read in the comments of the video I watched that the guy that was in the chat, like that sent it, he sent another super chat that was like, no, like listen, it's okay, like, you know, I you know, you don't have to apologize. It's fine. Like, it's you know, it's a mistake. You misread my name. It's fine. Like,
yeah, like We've belabored the point at this point. Like,
yeah.
But anyways, in the meantime, we will be preparing for chapter, I almost said 102, 1002.
102.
Back to the beginning. We're going to be preparing for that in the meantime, chapter 1002 of One Piece. While you're waiting, you can wait with us on our Discord server. You can find links to that on our social media at Paramecia Cast on at Paramecia Cast on Twitter. Ooh, Paramecia Fancast literally everywhere else. If you happen to listen to podcasts on YouTube, our podcasts do go up there. It just takes a bit more time because YouTube is poopoo caca.
Yeah.
Our podcasts normally go out. You can find that mainly on paramisiafancast.libsyn.com, but when it's not there, you can find it on your podcatchers. Not that when it's not there, you can find it instead on your podcatcher of choice. Yeah, if you happen to have a podcaster where we're not on there, let us know. We can probably figure that out.
I will say, I just logged into the Libsyn to check some shit the other day, and I guess there's a new, so we can now put our stuff on, like, the Amazon Music, like, RSS thing.
No way.
So, like, I'm gonna try it with this episode, like, after I put up this episode. So, if you search us on Amazon Music, you will might be able to find us.
Yeah. You know, who fucking knows? But, and, as a little parting note, maybe one day we will do a fucking VTuber podcast. You don't know. You're not the masters of us. you're beyond our control. You have no control over us. We must talk about... I have a mouth, therefore I must talk about VTubers.